If you find yourself having to reformat your brief's footnotes one by one, I've got a time-saving solution for you coming up. Hi, I'm Deborah Savager with LegalOfficeGuru.com, the resource for legal professionals using Microsoft Office. And in this series, I'm talking about how to meet specific brief formatting requirements. We've talked previously about changing the normal or base font of your brief to meet a court's briefing requirements. Changing the font, typeface, and size there, rather than selecting all the text and changing it using the font dropdowns on the Home tab, allows that change to cascade down to other elements like headers and footers. But what if your court has additional font requirements? Colorado, for example, requires that footnotes be the same size as the regular brief text. In Microsoft Word, while the footnote text styles will adopt the typeface setting of the normal style, it's usually sized by default 2 points smaller than the normal style. How do you fix that? If you need to tweak the settings of a particular style, first you have to figure out what style you're looking at. Word has a couple of different ways for you to do that, but to me, the most straightforward is to use the Reveal formatting pane. Just click your cursor into the piece of text you're curious about and press Shift F1. That will bring up the Reveal formatting pane on the right. Check the box next to Distinguish Style Source to ensure you can see what formatting comes from the name style. You'll notice that because my paragraph is sitting in the middle of a footnote, the paragraph style is identified as footnote text. If I click on that blue hyperlink, that's going to take me to the style dialog box with the footnote text style already selected. To change the style of the footnotes globally, click Modify. Then use the font size drop-down to change it. By the way, if you want this change to be permanently applied to whatever template you're using, click the radio button next to New Documents Based on this Template. I generally caution users to leave the Automatically Update checkbox unchecked, as it can have some unintended consequences. Once you click OK, all your footnotes, present and future, will be resized to meet your court's requirements. Hey, if this video has helped you, be sure to subscribe to this channel and hit the notification bell so you won't miss new videos in this series. And if you're in the middle of writing a brief, you're probably including a table of authorities, which can be a bona fide minefield. Let me help. Download my free Table of Authorities pre-published checklist, which shows you the 10 most common problems you'll run into with TOA, with links to helpful articles and videos on how to fix them. To make sure yours is up to standards before you print or PDF your next brief, click on the link above or in the description below and download your checklist today.